For one of my projects I need to spot weld thin sheet metal. The mechanics of the welder that I built for this purpose consists of 3D printed parts, 6mm brass tubes with 3mm copper wires soldered to them and an M3 screw as swivel joint. In terms of electronics, only a so-called supercapacitor and a step-down converter are required. The capacitor is soldered to the two brass tubes of the spot welder via wires that should be as short and thick as possible. A very high current is required for the welding process and the energy stored in the capacitor should not be dissipated in the supply lines. The capacitance of the device is 325 farads with a maximum voltage of 2.7 volts. The step-down converter is connected to the 12 volts line of an old computer power supply and set to an output voltage of 2 volts. The initial 0.4 volts was the residual charge from the last weld and it takes about 2 minutes to reach that 2 volts. With the capacitor charged, the device is prepared for a first weld. The sheets to be joined are from a peanut can. The paint must be removed with sandpaper before welding. The material thickness is 0.15 mm. When welding, the clamp must be pressed together for about 1 second, by then the capacitor is discharged to about 0.6 volts. The current flowing during this time heats the steel sufficiently to melt the metal and join the two sheets reliably. The close-up shows that the solder on the lower breast tube is melting partly due to the heat generated. Brazing the copper wire is probably better. The still image shows that the sheets glow bright red at the weld point. Under the microscope it is clearly visible that the sheets melted at the surface, both the upper and the lower sheet. The area around the welding spot has changed color due to oxidation processes caused by the heat. The weld spot can be broken by twisting the two sheets. Another look through the microscope shows that both sheets were indeed fused together. After the separation, a piece of the lower sheet is stuck to the upper sheet and a hole can be seen in the center of the lower sheet. It's important to remember that the energy stored in a capacitor increases squared with the voltage. If the device is charged to 2.5 volts, the copper electrodes burn a hole in both sheets during the welding process. Although both sheets stick together, the connection is not as sturdy as if there was no hole. If you want to weld thicker sheets, you should implement a higher capacitance to allow the current to flow for a longer period of time. If the voltage gets too high, we enter the area of spark erosion, as I already demonstrated in the corresponding video series. A spark jumps at the contact point and the metal in the plasma is melted so quickly that it flies away from the electrode as glowing droplets. Steel is removed instead of welding the steel plates. As told before, high current at low voltage ensures good spot welds. With a charging time of about 2 minutes between two spots, this simple device isn't suitable for frequent welders. At least you should consider a more powerful step-down converter. For now, this simple, albeit imperfect device fully meets my spot welding needs. More on why I must spot weld steel sheets in a coming video. As always, the build instructions of the simple spot welder including the 3D files are available on my website. There you'll also find a donate button which you can use to send me the equivalent of more cans of peanuts if you'd like to compensate me for my development of this and other open source projects. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!